kani kadai ka Batik CCTV bat pidang pet ya ka kubur bamankasni belawan rasa pi tak ko umrupa ringkat bat ko orange Nissan lom sokpo near Fabricate Shillong.
New Nissan Kicks bookings open now.
U Menteri Rangba Kejela U Konrad K. Sangma haka khat pratri gujli u arjar khat khandai ula punkup buram ya ki samla pule ki ba pas bha syakmat bat ki ba la poiru haka kerdan top 10 bat top 20 jongka examine secondary school leaving certificate bat higher secondary school leaving certificate jong usnem arjar khat khandai haka jing yalang ka ba syongkun ka ba la long state convention center Shillong. Yagabala penbek bat penbit penbiang daga University of Science and Technology Meghalaya harangkat ka jingye treilang bat ka ERDF Foundation Guwahati. Haganegasni la sakhi langdau menteri katnat pule puthi uma Lakman Rumbui, u menteri katnat Revenue and Disaster Management uma Kerman Shala, bat unong aibuit ka sorkar jela u Dr. Didi Lapang. Kini kisamla ki bala pas bahasa khaman kila yok pediang ru dagi laptop, ki digital tablets, ki mementos, bat ki sernot na kakti u menteri rangba, bat na ki kenrem ki lendahan ki belasak hilang hagani ke sengi. Lasak hiru hagani ke jingyalang penkup buram, dau chancellor ke USTM u Mahbubul Hoq, bat ki principal jongki school beper-beper kentup ru, ya ki kimi kikpa, bat ki bahaya ngasem jongki samla pule. Kidan hado nyo pusangut ki samla pule ki bala pas bahagi ki examen SSLC bat HSSLC jong snem arjar khat kendai ki bala syak pun ku buram hagani ke sengi.
I on behalf of the government urge upon you, don't rest, work hard. We have seen that in our state we are still lagging behind, whether in the area of research, whether in the area of teaching profession, quality teaching profession, teachers, especially in the All India service. As I said before, that you are brilliant, you are hardworking. Please don't follow the crowd. Be innovative. Let somebody follow you. Have your own life and aim high. In today's world, opportunity is plenty. It is up to you how you synchronize your ability to work, how you synchronize your mind, and how you synchronize your ideas towards your goal. So it is very, very important. Coming back to All India Service, we have seen for the last 5 years, there is nobody from our state of Meghalaya who is qualified. It is not that they are not trying. Maybe the effort is less. Honorable Chief Minister has initiated a program where the brilliant student, their fees have been reimbursed by the government. Why? Because we need the people from our state to succeed. So I believe that you, amongst you, not only you, somebody who is not have the privilege to enter this convention hall through their effort, who are not in the top 10 or top 20, they are those our students also, they are not lagging behind. As I used to say, that marks is not the end of the road. Marks is not everything. Talent, idea, and more importantly, hard work is very important.
It's great to see that children from all over the state today have been able to really achieve and come to the top. I want to take 1 minute though to tell you about the not so pleasant things that I think we should think about. And this time, if you notice in the examinations, when the results came out, especially for the class 10, 50% of our students did not pass. Did not pass. There were close to 54,000 students who gave the exam, and about 25,000 of them did not clear the exams. So yes, we are here celebrating, I guess, in one way, and honoring each and every one of you out here. But when you look at the other side, I think there's a lot to be done. And that is what really, for me as the Chief Minister and my entire cabinet, this really is one of the biggest challenges that we have. And it's not that it's been like this year. It's been the trend for the past 5 to 6 years. We have seen the numbers that have been going is anything between 50% to 55% is what the average pass percentage has been. We need to be concerned. Because this is the human resource, or this is the manpower, you can call it, that is going to run our state and our country. And as we all know, that education and an educated and a qualified workforce and human resource will be much more productive than a workforce that is not educated. As an economy, and as an economist also, I'm not an economist really, but I take a lot of interest in economy, we really try to ensure that the productivity is there for each individual. We want to ensure that nobody is not productive. And we also want to ensure that how we can improve the productivity of every individual by minimizing the number of hours that they spend, but improving the productivity that they do. I talk about my colleagues and myself. A lot of people sometimes, you know, get really shocked to hear that we spend anything between 14 to 16 hours working every day. Our day starts at 8 in the morning and finishes at 12 o'clock in the night. So people think that, my God, whole day they're working 16 hours. But if you go down and actually write down every hour what you're doing, we realize that the productivity part is hardly 2 to 3 hours. Rest of the time we're actually talking to too many people. I want to change that. Many countries, people outside the world, you'll see, they've got us limited hours to work. 7 hours and that's it. It's illegal to work beyond that. You know that? Illegal. The employer may be fined and put in jail for making somebody work for more than 7 hours a day. There's a logic to it. So coming back to the point that therefore it is so important for our society to be productive. And that's really what we as a government will look at and go back to the fact that there is a problem that we're facing today. And I keep repeating this everywhere. Education is like the blood of the body. And if education is not there, we will not have the kind of doctors that we want. We will not have the kind of entrepreneurs that we want. We will not have the kind of officers that we want. So therefore, education runs through the entire system.
A laptop from our Honorable Education Minister, sir, and a certificate from the Revenue Minister, sir. Yo vino a Sharapa.